Chris Hune, if you weren't successful, what sort of leader would Nick Clegg make?
I think Nick Clegg would be an excellent leader. I mean, I've always said that I think Nick has enormous, enormous qualities. I've also said that I think probably not this time. But
so
I
he wouldn't
no
be
doubt...
a calamity?
Oh, absolutely not.
So why have you issued a briefing document called Calamity Clegg?
I haven't.
This has come from your party, this has come from your office on Friday to the Politics Show.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm sorry, I didn't see it, so I don't know.
Well, don't you know what goes out of your office?
Well, I didn't. It's quite impossible to check everything that goes out of the office. This is a large campaign going right the way across the country. But I can assure you that's not had my authorisation.
This is a lengthy briefing document listing various elements where you say that Nick Clegg has not done his job very well, that he flip-flops, you know, he keeps changing his mind. What has he forgotten what he said before, or has he changed his mind again? Written in those sort of terms.
Well, I do think very clearly that we have had a series of issues where it is not clear where Nick stands. I don't think it's clear where Nick stands on Trident, for example. I've said very clearly that I'm against replacing Trident.
Can I reply?
Nick has said, of course, let me finish, and then of course you can say. I don't think we know where Nick stands on issues about public services reform. He's given journalists the impression, for example, that he's in favour of school vouchers. Well, he's not retracted that.
Hang on.
I don't think we know where Nick stands, for example, on the National Health Service, because he says he won't rule out, in an interview with
Nick
the Scotsman, he won't rule out the question of continental health insurance models, and then he's saying, no, he's happy with party policy. So
Let Nick Clegg
answer.
And then
finally, on PR, he said, no, we mustn't
make it the be-all and end-all. You've had a good go.
And then,
Nick Clegg.
Chris knows very well. I've said it to him privately. I've said it publicly until I'm blue in the face. I'm against vouchers. I'm against social insurance. My position on Trident is very clear.
Why did you say you wouldn't rule out
social insurance? I have said it. I've said it countless times. I said it to you yesterday. I've said it on my website. I've said it. But hang on. Can I, with respect, Chris, this contest is not about me meeting false challenges which you put up to me. It is about me saying what I think the Liberal Democrats need to do to the country, for the country, to make Britain a more liberal place.
That's come from your office. Okay. Do you think you owe him an apology?
It's the first time I've seen this, so I have
but
absolutely
called
no...
Calamity Clegg, that name will stick.
I don't think so at all.
I've said to you very clearly.
We have to make clear what potential differences are during this campaign.
But they have to be real differences.
I entirely agree.
Chris.
And I think that there are real differences here. And you are trying to say, I mean, I've said absolutely clearly that there can be no case for replacing Trident after the non-proliferation talks in 2010,
because you are trying to keep open the option of replacing with an all-singing, all-dancing Trident system. I've said it to him privately, I've said it again publicly, I'll say it again now. I think creating synthetic differences between us which don't exist, particularly when I've explained over and over again what my position is, very, very clearly.
You haven't gone on the record. You still haven't retracted the two things that you were saying to the Observer,
Chris,
and that
I have, Chris, until I'm blue in the face.
Chris,
I have.
Why?
Do you want to do it again?
When I challenge
you, Nick.